What's up, guys? It's your boy Chronic Estrada, and we're here with
Young Kari.
All right, guys. So this is story time. We're talking about a time where
we've never told anybody about. Like, this is top secret
between like us.
So we told each other that night. Like, we're like, we're not gonna talk about this. Like, this is too crazy. But it was my bad. So we're recording now. So we're gonna tell you about it. Let's get it started.
You wanna tell them or me?
It's up to you.
All right, so how if you tell us. Okay, so this girl texted me. She was at a friend's house. She's from high school. Told me if I wanted to hang out and, like, go over and stuff.
And I was with him. Like, I was here at his house. It was about, like, a year and a half ago.
Yeah, this was
It was my back. And at the time, I had a girlfriend. He didn't. He was straight. So she was, like, she's from Corpus, though. And she came down, and she was visiting family. And she was, like, home alone, she says. And so we pulled up. It's like not very far. How long was it? Like 10 minutes? Like a 10-minute walk. And so we pulled up. It was like 11:30. Yeah, around 11:30. Yeah, we pulled up. And it was just shady from the start. Like,
all right, so we pulled up. And God damn.
Dude, it's just crazy. Like, I can't believe it actually happened.
Okay, so we went over there. We knocked at the door. They let us in and everything. We were just talking. It was, like, really boring.
Yeah, we were chilling, living in, like... Because his intentions were to go. You feel me? And I was just there, wingman, just chilling. I'm just chilling on my phone. I'm sitting there just, like, waiting for this nigga to go smash. So I'm waiting for him. And I'm sitting there in the living room. And, like, we're all sitting there in the living room. They're on this couch. We're on this couch. And, like, we're just talking. And she's like, so, like, trying to get to know us better. And we're just like...
Like, fuck off.
Yeah, like, just let him hit.
Right.
You never know that I could have gotten that machine.
All right, so.
Yeah.
It actually happened, boys. We went into the bedroom.
And I stayed in the living room.
Yeah, some things happened, like, still version of.
Yeah. Time got a little cut short.
Yeah, things went bad.
So, all right, so he told me he was like, because she was like, so you're going to stay here? And I was like, yeah, I'll chill here in the living room. Because he told me, I'll be there for like 30 minutes max. And I was like, all right. I was like, that's straight. I'm going to chill here, probably watch some YouTube. So I'm on my phone, I'm chilling, and this nigga's in there for 45 minutes. And I'm just chilling in the living room. And I'm like texting, spamming this nigga's phone. I'm like, where the fuck you at? Where the fuck you at? You almost done. And she told me, she was like, my dad be getting home around 1, so y'all gotta leave before then. And it was like 12 o'clock, or not even, it was like 12:15. So we're in there and we're chilling, and I hear a truck pull up, and I'm like,
that's when things went wrong.
Oh, hell yeah. So I'm sitting on the couch, and the couch is right when you walk in the room, in the living room, and I'm like, and like, I didn't know, like, you know how, like, I didn't know if the truck was just driving by or if it was pulling up to the crib. So I go look at the window, and that nigga pulled up to the crib. That, and big ass nigga dog. Get out. He's a big ass.
Are you scared?
I mean, I wasn't scared. I wasn't doing shit with the girl.
But you're inside of his house.
Yeah, but like, it was his knees. Like, I was like, this nigga, he didn't want to get this shit fucked up. Because there's no back door. This is, you go to the front door, you come out to the front door. Like, that's all there is. And he was in the front of the truck. He's sitting in his car, and I see him on his phone. And he's chilling. It's a big old 4x4 truck and shit, and this nigga's, how tall is he, like?
Fucking.
Like 6'5"?
He's pretty tall.
6'5", like at least 245, big ass nigga dog, and I'm just like.
Fat boy.
I'm just like, this shit ain't gonna end well. So, I didn't want to burst into the room, I don't want to just go into the room, because I'm not trying to see this nigga's cock and shit. So I was like, I'm straight, I'm gonna chill here. So I'm calling this nigga now, I'm FaceTiming him, I'm like, bro. We gotta get the fuck out of here. We got to fucking go. And this nigga's not answering his phone. And I finally got to the point where, like, the guy was in his car for, like, 10 minutes of just waiting. Like,
you're just in there.
Just chilling in his car. And I'm like, this nigga's weird as fuck. Like, what is he doing? And I'm just spamming Ethan's phone. And he doesn't answer. So I go in. This nigga was laying there on the bed. They weren't even doing shit. Well, that's what I saw. I don't know. Were y'all doing shit?
Nah.
They were just chilling?
Yeah.
So, I went in the room and I was like, Nick, we gotta go. She was like, why? And I was like, nigga, your dad's here. She's like, it's not my dad, it's my uncle. I was like, that nigga's big as fuck. And she's like, oh, she's like, he don't care. He don't care.
Oh, yeah, he did.
And we're like, you sure? She's like, yeah, he's cool. He's real chill. She's like, he's probably drunk and high. He won't care. And we're like, are you sure? He's like, yeah. So I'm like, all right. Then I'm like, you keep doing you, Ethan. I'll get you back in the living room. So I go, I'm chilling in the living room. And then I hear the door to the car close. And that's when shit went down. So he comes out the car, and I was like, all right. I was like, yeah. He like, banging on the door, because I guess the nigga didn't have a key, I don't know. And I didn't want to open it. Like, nigga, it's not my house. I'm going to open the door, and it's not even my fucking house. So I'm like, nigga, I'm not going to open it. So the girl wasn't coming out the room, though, so I was like, I guess I gotta open the fucking door for this nigga. He's high as hell, whatever. So I go, I open the door for him, and he looks at me, he's like, who the fuck are you? And I'm like, nigga, I'm here with my friend Ethan. He's in the room. And he's like, and I never told him about this, like, we never talked about, like, we talked about it, told each other, like,
We talked about it all night.
It was scary. I know, like, we didn't, like, I didn't really, like, at the moment, I wasn't, like, it wasn't going through my head, like, nigga, this nigga about to fuck me up, like, so then I finally told him, I was like, yeah, I'm here with Ethan, and he's in the room with your niece, whatever, and he's like, my niece, and I'm like, yeah, and he's like, and he said her name, like,
my niece?
I don't want to say her name. What are you going to call it, like, call it?
Girl.
Alright, we'll call her girl. He's like, you're talking about a girl? And I'm like,
that's not dumb.
Alright, we're gonna call her Cupcake. He's like, you're talking about Cupcake? And I'm like, yeah, Cupcake. And I'm like, he's like, throw in the room? I'm like, yeah, why? He's like, nigga, that's my room. I'm like, fuck. So this nigga goes and he's like, just push me out of the way. Not really, like, he don't really beat my
nigga ass. Like, almost broke the door down.
He just like pushed me out of the way and like, he walks into the room and that nigga Ethan's in there, and
I'm like, okay, that nigga walked in, I went behind the bed, dumbass nigga tried to crawl over the bed, I did.
And, okay, so this nigga has never done anything like this, I swear he's never done nothing like this before.
So he just took off, boys.
This nigga is sitting on the bed like this, like, his pants, not off, but they off, but they not off, you feel me? And I'm still walking behind the nigga, and I see Ethan in there, and the girl's like, in her bra or whatever, like, I ain't really doing nothing too much. And this nigga walks and he's like, what the fuck? He's like, what are you doing, Cupcake? And then Ethan's like, oh, hell no. He didn't say that, but, like, you could tell, like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I was scared.
This nigga, you scared?
He's finna cry.
All right, so he, like, goes on top of the bed. He didn't really go under, like, okay, so, like, this is the bed. Ethan's right here. The niggas are here. And he goes, he, like, tries to grab for Ethan. Ethan, like, goes, he, like, runs around the bed. And we dip the fuck out of there. You don't even, nigga, I'm not
nigga
fast.
Nigga starts chasing
I'm us. Not fast, I'm not fast. But, nigga, I dip the fuck out. I was running faster than this nigga. Cause I don't know why I was scared. I didn't fuck her. I was straight.
I didn't fuck her.
You would've. Hey, bitch. Alright, and so this nigga hops in his truck. And it's like one of those streets that just goes straight. Like, from his house, we just go. Four blocks down.
No damn place.
And then he goes, like, left. And, like, it's, like, a couple turns into his house. But this nigga hops in his truck, and you hear that. That's one of those big ass trucks. Like, and I'm like, oh, hell nah. So, of course, he's faster than us in his truck, right? So, we're like, what the fuck do we do? Like, we're like, what do we do? Like, what are we going to do? And so, Ethan's like, nigga, let's turn on this street. And let's turn on this street. And let's turn on this street. And I'm like,
he's trying to zigzag.
Yeah, like trying to trick this nigga the fuck out or whatever. So I was like, all right, nigga, let's go. So we're running. We go down this street, take a ride. We're like going everywhere, like dude, all the streets. And we're just booking it. Like, I'm tired as fuck. I can't breathe, nigga. I'm tired as hell. And this nigga just keeps running. And then finally, like, we don't hear his truck no more. But, like, we know he's still in the area because, like, we didn't run very far. But this is the part that was kind of scary because, so, I was on my phone the whole time we were there, right? My phone was on, like, 4%. And then this nigga, this is at the time when, like,
I had that iPhone, like,
yeah, iPhone 5, I'm looking at shit. Yeah, I don't even know if shit had service on it or nothing, but we didn't know where the hell we were at. Let's just say it like that. We didn't know where the fuck we were at. We were lost in B-ville. We were lost. It's, like, 1 o'clock in the morning. we didn't know what the fuck to do. So we just decided to, like, I could not waste this last 4% of my phone to look up where we were going. And this dumbass didn't even know his address.
We were lost.
Lost as fuck. Really, so yeah, we walked around till about, it's like 1 o'clock when we got lost. Like, we realized we were lost. It was like 1:15 when we, like, it's like 1:15 and we were like, dude, what the fuck are we gonna do? And he's like, nigga, just use the last 4%. This one, I had like an iPhone. I had an iPhone 5 too, but like, it was like, I don't know, that shit died quick as hell. So I was not trying to waste the last 4%. Like, if I really need to, I would call my mom up. It was 1 o'clock in the morning, and my mom didn't know, like, I was out there doing that shit. So I didn't want to call her.
Right.
And so we walk around for about, like, 30 minutes, like a solid 30 minutes.
Just zigzagging around, boys.
Just trying to find our way back home. Trying to find our way back home. They got crazy as shit. Alright, so then, y'all never believe where we ended up at.
Back at her house.
Back at the bitch's house. Oh my god. We ended up back at a girl's house. And the truck was there, and the light in the room that we were in, the light was on, and I was like, nigga, you like, we should go ding dong ditch this nigga's house. And of course, he told him, like, yeah, let's do it. So
this,
like,
nigga starts running before I even get to the door.
Yeah, I was like, this nigga's big, bro. Like, I don't know what we were thinking. We were like, let's just do it. Fuck it. Like, we're 12 or 13 years old.
Get on time.
We were like, dude, we gotta make memories out of this. You know what I mean? So let's do it. So we go, and this nigga's faster than me. So I'm like, you go knock, and I'm a dip. I'll hide behind his truck, and he goes. And the guy, he turns around. I was already down the street. I was gone. I ain't waiting for you, Ethan. And so the guy opens, and he was like, let's hide right here. So we go, and every house has the trash cans, right? Like, we go and hide behind the trash can, and we see this nigga open the door, and he goes, and he's like screaming, like, it's like 2 o'clock in the morning. We're like, nigga, why are you screaming? He's like, if it's that little niggas that was in my house earlier, and I catch y'all, I'm gonna whoop the fuck out y'all. And we're like, I was like, oh, hell no. Yeah, we were like, rack, dude, like, take it easy, man. And like, I kind of wanted to pop out and be like, what's up, nigga, I'm right here. But like, I was like, nah. I was like, nah, I'm not gonna do that. So he goes back inside. We wait about 5 minutes. And I was like, we gotta do it again. Like, we gotta do it again. We didn't get the reaction we wanted. We gotta do it again. He's like, all right. He's like, you knock this time. I'm like, all right. So, but he goes with me. Like, he were right by the door. And this nigga knocked with me. And
after this reaction, boys, we were just out there.
Yeah, we were fucking, this nigga is crazy as fuck. So, like, this is how it was. I said, door was already fucking open. Like, he was waiting. This nigga was waiting for us at the door.
Nigga just, like, pulls the door open. He's, like, right there.
Like, it was straight, like, oh, I missed it. I was like, and he opens the door. Like, two knocks, and nigga opens the door. Like, we didn't even turn around yet to run. And we're like, fuck, bro. Like, this nigga about to beat our asses. And he, like, look at him. I look back. Ethan's already running, and I'm like, nigga, I gotta dip. But y'all know me, I'm always wearing my slides. I don't wear shoes unless I'm, like going to school.
Damn sandals behind, boys.
You know what, I had a little white Jordan sandals, you know what I'm talking about? And yeah, I think Ryan, I know you know, Cody, I know y'all know. So I was wearing my little white Jordan sandals, and I'm trying to dip the fuck out. I'm running. And them hoes, y'all know if y'all got slides, I know that them hoes be bending back like that, all broken and stuff. So I'm running, and my sandals falling off. I'm not gonna stop to. Like, I'm not. Like, I'm good. I'm not gonna stop. Like, we're running on the sidewalk anyways. Like, I'm not running in the middle of the street. Nothing. It's like, I'm not trying to go back and get my slide. I'm not. We're gonna risk a slide to get my ass beat. So I dipped the fuck out, and I'm running. This nigga's big as fuck. He ain't gonna chase us. I knew he ain't gonna chase us. So I'm running, and
too big for that shit.
That boy looked like a damn McDouble. Boy looked like fucking McDouble, plain and dry, and so we're running, and then my slide falls off, and I'm just like, Ethan, my slide fell off. And he was like, fuck your slide. And I was just like, nigga, fuck my slide. So I'm running, and then I see the nigga, like, I didn't know what happened to him. I don't know if he went inside. I don't know if he hopped in his truck. I don't know what the fuck he did. My slide wasn't too far behind, so I ran back. I got that bitch up, you feel me? And then I kept running, and we knew we had to get to Ethan's house from there. So we got back to Ethan's house, and we come in this exact room right here. And we're like,
It was like way different back then. Like, I had like a big ass bed.
Yeah, he had a big ass bed, and we're like sitting here, and we're just like, bro, what the fuck did we just do?
Like, we're just talking about like, what would have happened if that nigga would have grabbed us?
Like, dude, we could have got the fucking. Nigga, we wouldn't even be here today. That nigga was humongous, bro. Like, I was like,
probably would have came back with the couple.
Imagine like LeBron James beating your, like, okay, imagine you knock at the door, and LeBron James fucking opens it. That nigga was big. And back then, like, I wasn't, like, right now I'm not saying I'm tall, but like, I was not. I was like 4'8". This nigga was like 5 foot. Like, nigga, we was short. Like, we was. We couldn't.
Yeah, I was pretty short. I grew a lot.
Like, we could not fucking probably even lift up a bar, nigga. Like, this is the summer in between 6th and 7th grade. Like, so, this is like.
Nigga. You want to just end it here, boys?
Nigga, I don't know. Like, that shit is just crazy, bro. Like, so the lesson, the story, like, the moral of the story is.
Be careful what you're doing, boys.
If you're going to go to a girl's house, make sure the coast is clear. Always take your nigga with you. Someone better than me, though, because, like, I was scared as fuck. I was not, like, someone big. Like, you need to have someone. Like, if it were to be yesterday today, though, that nigga would not fuck with us. It's nigga Ethan. You feel me?
Fuck that one, dude.
Nigga, I don't know, but, like, I don't know. We were pussies back then. I mean, I still know. He's, like, not pussy no more, but, like, that shit was scary as fuck. I would do something like that again. That shit was kind of fun, though. Like, it was pretty funny. It was funny, like, okay.
It was funny.
But, like, after it all happened, like, in the moment.
We were scared as hell.
Yeah, in the moment, we were like, nigga, I'm sorry.
Like, at the time, we were scared as hell, but when we got back here, we were just like.
Like, you're like, nigga, that's so stupid. Like, and, the next night, I stayed the night here again, and this thing had sodas, right? Like, you know, yeah, cream soda. No one drinks that shit. And we, he had his little Polaris, and we, like, whipped that bitch, and we had a box in the back, and he had leftover chicken. We put a condom on the chicken, left it on his doorstep, shook up like 3 sodas and just chunked them both of that nigga's yard, bro. And that nigga was crazy. And then the next morning, that was like 10 o'clock at night. It wasn't even
the box was gone, bro. He ate our chicken. He ate our
chicken. He's a big old black guy.
Big old dude, bro.
He ate the chicken, bro.
He said, KFC? Don't mind if I do.
Took the condom on that bitch.
Bone and all, nigga.
Dude, he's crazy as fuck. And then, we've never talked to that girl since then. Cupcake, fuck if you're watching this video, Cupcake.
Fuck you.
Yeah, fuck you.
Fuck you, whatever he is to you.
Your uncle, nigga. I don't care if it's your uncle or your daddy. Fuck you, and fuck him. But, it was probably the craziest thing that's ever happened to us. And,
honestly, about it, if y'all try to listen to the next story time, it's going to be pretty crazy. We got
plenty of stories.
The time that I blew myself up.
Dude, that shit was crazy. I wasn't there, but he told me about
it. In my backyard.
In the backyard.
With the gas can.
With the gas can?
Alright, guys. So we'll be back with another video pretty soon. He's going to vlog tomorrow. Be sure to go check out his channel at Young Kyrie 2.
Happy birthday, Cameron.
Alright, guys, and we're out.